Another electronic device bites the dust. This is not a very complicated piece of electronics, but when something like this dies, I like to take it apart and see how it worked. We've had this for quite a few years. As far as I know, it's never been dropped. The display was getting to where it was going dim and then brightening up and dimming, and it made it almost impossible to set the time or the alarm. The clock and the alarm still function perfectly. If you can't see to set it, it's not much use to you. When you go to install a battery, you need to push on that spring to put the battery in. If you get in here and you somehow push down on that, you'll suddenly notice the spring has disappeared. It has fallen inside the case. So then you'll have to take it apart and take that spring, put it back in there like that. I took a piece of tape, put it across there and down both sides. That makes it a little less likely to fall out of there. And you will notice how easily these very fine wires break off. So you'll have to pay attention to where they were connected and be prepared to re-solder them. And as you set this, all of these click. Piezoelectric buzzer, that's your alarm. There are three screws holding the case together and another eight that are holding the circuit board, the display, and retaining the buttons. When I took the circuit board off, first thing I noticed was these little buttons, and they're all covered with like a piece of packing tape. And these are like clickers. It's like the old kid's toy or noisemaker. You'd click them, or you'd click it, put it down the table, and it would jump. Sometimes they'd call it a frog. If you listen to this, every time you push on a button, it's collapsing that piece and making contact with the circuit board. All these buttons have a little piece of tape over the top of them. At first, I thought that was for insulation. Get hold of that piece of tape and we pull it off. We find that tape is the only thing that's holding them in position. Kind of clever in one sense, sloppy in another. And these two are held on the same way. And then no particular care for assembly. Just leave the wires hang out, bent over. It's probably good enough. In any case, you can't see it. This is the LED that backlights the display when you push this button. And you can just pull that off of there. Under here is the chip for the clock and alarm, and it has been securely potted and sealed to the circuit board. Across here is another piece of tape holding the remaining two buttons, and it goes across the ribbon cable leading up to the display. I pulled that piece of tape off that was holding these two buttons in place, and as I pulled it off, it was trying to loosen this ribbon cable, which appeared to just be attached by glue or tape. There's no solder connection on here. And you can kind of catch the edge of a piece of tape on the back side of the board and on this back side of this display, there's a piece of tape that I peeled off that ran down the length of this ribbon. They use tape quite a bit to hold this together or as a strain relief or whatever their intended purpose was. And if we look a little closer at these connections, that's barely connected. There doesn't appear to be anything here. There's quite a few places along here where whatever the material is that's part of the trace, which kind of looks like carbon, has been left on these tabs. Barely connected here, nothing here. This left some along in these connections that left some of the material from the ribbon behind. a little bit here, and these are basically non-existent. If it was just glue or tape that was holding this together, and tape and that will fail and start to come apart given time, that would be one explanation for the progressive failure on this, where the display on this side was the worst. Anyway, I got 11 screws out of the deal. I'm always looking for screws.